how are you today? I am so excited that you are here and following me, and I appreciate you so much for tuning in. Today we are going to talk about your chronic pain score. Do you know your chronic pain score? My name is Dr. Jeanette DeWitt. I am a chronic pain specialist and a doctor of physical therapy. And if you do not know your chronic pain score, why not? And actually, what is a chronic pain score? Well, here, if you have chronic pain, you know that the 0 to 10 scale often doesn't apply to you. In a standard medical office, what you're gonna see is rate your pain 0 to 10. 0 is no pain, 10 is emergency room. I actually use a 0 to 100 scale, and I quantify that because sometimes chronic pain is not sharp shooting pain, but it's dull, achy pain. Sometimes it's muscle tightness. Sometimes it's like lack of mobility, but it's intense lack of mobility, like I'm stuck, I can't move type of a symptom. But often, if you have chronic pain, that 0 to 10 scale doesn't apply to you because your symptoms are like a 12 or a 15. They're way off the chart on that standard scale. And so being able to quantify a 0 to 100 often is much, much more helpful. But even more important than that, if you've had diagnostic testing, like an X-ray, an MRI, and those come back negative, you hear crickets, right? You're like, where's the pain coming from? Why do I have pain? How do I quantify my pain if my pain does not fit into the 0 to 10 scale? If my pain is not showing up as a reasonable explanation on an MRI, on a CT scan, on an X-ray, why do I have this pain and how do I quantify it? Well, I use a chronic pain scale. Or a chronic pain score. And what that is I actually walk people through a series of movements from head to toe, and I scan what those movements actually mean. And what I find is that people who have a low chronic pain score, meaning they have not very much many movements that create pain, they are going to get better faster. But if they have a lot of scores or things that are out of symmetry or movements that hurt, and they have a high chronic pain score, their symptoms are going to take longer to calm down. Now, how do you know what your chronic pain score is? Well, first of all, you have to go through the chronic pain assessment, and it's a series of movements, like I said, from head to toe, that compares the movements to movements within the body. So for example, I might have you do an arm movement that comes up. I might have you do a head movement that looks down, but it also looks down to the left, it looks down to the right, and we're comparing what is each movement doing and how does it compare from one side of the body to the other side of the body. And when we make those comparisons, we find out how many areas of the body are not symmetrical. Now, I've been practicing since 1998, and I will tell you that when people come in and they have more areas of the body that are not symmetrical, meaning they're out of alignment, or they have postural changes that are happening that affect their body more on one side than the other, or maybe the front side of their muscles are tighter and the back side of the muscles are lengthened and elongated and stretched out, or just in a weaker position. When those things happen, people have more pain. And it's not going to show up on an X-ray. It's not going to show up on an MRI. It's not going to show up on a CT scan. These things are happening because things are not symmetrical. Movements are not symmetrical. The body is not in the alignment that it should be in. And it's different from one side of the body to the next, and it's different from the front side of the body to the back side of the body. And that is why people are having pain. The root cause of the pain is not a disc issue, is not a stenosis issue, is not an impingement issue. Those things may be happening, but that's not the root cause of the pain. The root cause of the pain is the body is not in symmetry. And when the body comes closer into symmetry, And the chronic pain assessment score is lower because more things are in symmetry, then the body feels better. So what happens when those chronic pain assessment shows lots of asymmetries? Well, that's my job. That's my job, is to teach you how to bring your body back in symmetry through movement. Now, you can have somebody move you, like a chiropractor, a physical therapist like myself, massage therapist. You can also have people move you in ways that is passive, but through different modalities. So you could have somebody use acupuncture or dry needling, or you could have a mobilization done to you. These are all beneficial, and they can work, and they do work. I've used them myself. I've received that type of treatment myself. However, I have to wait for somebody else to move me. I have to wait for somebody else to do something to me. And generally speaking, that's like 2-3 times a week where I'm gonna go in for an appointment. And generally speaking, the standard approach is 2-3 times a week for 3-6 weeks or 4-6 weeks. So if I take the maximum of that 3 times a week for 6 weeks, that's 18 opportunities for someone else to help me feel better. Well, if I could learn how to get my chronic pain score down and correct my own asymmetries, and I could do that twice a day for 15 minutes to 30 minutes, in the first week, I'm gonna have 14 opportunities to get myself better, to bring my own body back into symmetry without waiting for somebody else. If I do that over 4 weeks, I think if I do the math right, that's 56 opportunities to make myself feel better, to bring myself back into symmetry without waiting for somebody else. So if the general standard treatment is 3 times a week for 6 weeks or 3 times a week for 4 weeks, I've got 12 to 18 opportunities where I have to wait for somebody else to make me feel better. Where if I learn how to move and bring my own body back into symmetry, in the same amount of time or 1 month, I can have 56 opportunities to make myself feel better and bring my chronic pain score down. Now, how do you know what assessment to do? Well, actually, if you go to my website at www.wellness-track.com, you can take a free chronic pain assessment and get your free chronic pain score. You're going to see that you can rate your movements as none, no problem at all. You can rate them as low, it's a low issue, a medium issue, or it's a high issue. If you have hardly any problems at all, you may not even think you need to take that assessment. But if you have a lot of low issue numbers, that's gonna tell you that, oh, you know, I'm probably gonna be able to use movement to fix myself rather quickly. If you have a lot of medium or a lot of high scores, meaning you have a lot of things out of symmetry and the things that are out of symmetry hurt a lot, then you know that it's gonna take a little bit longer and it's going to possibly require more types of movements to bring that score down. So if you find value in that and you think that that is helpful, I will tell you, go to that website, www.wellness-track.com, and take that free pain assessment. Get your chronic pain score and get like tangible proof that something is going on in your body with movement that feels yummy, meaning it feels good, or it feels yucky. But that's going to give you a lot more information than a diagnosis, because the diagnosis may actually not be the root cause of the problem. The root cause of the problem may be that you're out of symmetry, and that out of symmetry is actually causing you to have the diagnosis. I hope that you find value in this. If you do, please go ahead and comment in the feed below. If you have questions and you want to private message me, go ahead and do that. But more importantly, find out your pain score. Find out your chronic pain assessment score, because when you do that, that's going to give you a lot more information than on that 0 to 10 pain scale. That 0 to 10 pain scale tells you what your pain level is in the moment, but it doesn't tell you what your body is doing and when it's having pain. By going through those movements, you're going to learn exactly what areas of the body your body struggles with, and you're gonna find out what areas of the body actually are doing pretty okay. Thanks a lot. I hope this is helpful. Go take that chronic pain assessment and get your chronic pain score, and then let me know what that score is. I want to know, because I want to know if I can help you or if I can steer you in a different direction that gives you help as well. That chronic pain assessment score is going to give you lots of information, and more importantly, it's going to tell you what your next steps are. So go ahead and do that, and if I'm the right person to work with, I will tell you that, and if I think that you need to see a different type of specialist, I'm going to tell you that too. Thanks a lot, and have a great day.